apologize for the technical difficulties of loading the risers. We rehearse in two separate groups, so we very rarely, if ever, get to rehearse all together. And so it's always a bit of a struggle loading the risers at the concert. Hopefully, my back is to them as they come down the aisle. Did they actually dance? Did they do it? Maybe, a little bit, some of them. I hear some clapping, so some of them must have danced, so that's good. I can tell you that I've been treated to some very interesting dance moves as they've been coming down. So I don't know if they'll show you later. I told them that they had to practice because it's always harder in front of their parents. And I knew some of them wouldn't do it, but I hope some of you did. Some of you actually dance?
Yes.
Good. All right. That song, they had a lot of fun with, not always, but at least at the end, they had a lot of fun with. And that song is from Mardi Gras. I don't know how familiar you are with Mardi Gras, but in Mardi Gras, there's groups of people that travel in crews with a K, not like gang crews, but just like a fraternity almost. And they dress in a theme, and they go on a parade, and they're very generous. They throw out tokens and trinkets and beads and all sorts of things. And so we had our two crews coming down the aisle doing, you know, not stomping the ground, basically saying, this is my territory, this is my parade. And so I hopefully you got a little bit of that Mardi Gras flair, a little of the Mardi Gras spirit. I know it's not Mardi Gras time exactly, but it was when we started it. It was a while ago, huh? Our next piece is something you generally associate with this time of year, especially once your kids are up in high school and getting to graduation. It's a piece we hear, Mr. Brumbaugh and I joke, every year. We hear it at least once a year by someone auditioning for graduation. Someone always auditions with Good Riddance, every year, except for this year. So I think this one might be the first year no one did. But they're singing it, so I still got to hear it anyway. So we have a special guest for this one. Where is she? There she is. This is Ashley Nahila. She's gonna come and play guitar for us. She happens to be a big fan of the band who originally sang this song, and she's also an excellent guitar player. So I hope you enjoy Good Riddance. we're doing by ourselves, I am always surprised how many requests I get for this song every single year. It's a bop, yeah, as they tell me. It's a bop. It's requested by my high schoolers, it's requested by my middle schoolers. Everyone still seems to love this song. I'm really happy with the enduring legacy of this song. Most of you are probably familiar with the original Michael Jackson version of Man in the Mirror. It won't exactly sound like Michael Jackson, but the message remains the same. If we want to see the world and make it a better place, if we want to see it be a better place, then we have to look at ourselves first. What are we doing to make it a better place? How are we treating the people around us? Are we looking at the people around us? We've worked really hard with that message this semester. It's been a long journey for this chorus. This is the hardest piece that they've done, and it's very, very difficult. My high school choir did it, I can't remember, last year or 2 years ago, a different version, but same song. And it was difficult for them, and they struggled with it. And when they heard the junior high picked it, they're like, oh boy, like, are they gonna be able to do it? And I was like, I don't know. We'll see how hard they work. And they worked really, really hard. And I think at this point, pretty much all of them are proud of this, yes? Because they've worked really, really hard for it. So I hope you enjoy Man in the Mirror. We have two soloists to start us off. We have Amaya O'Donnell and Greta Stager. Yeah.